first speaker today is Dr. Bill Howard. Bill is the senior physician at the Arnold Palmer Sports Health Center at Union Memorial Hospital. And I can hear Ron's voice right now saying, Sandusky, that sounds like a promo in a Ravens broadcast. Today's Miller Lite, Good Call, brought to you by Bill Howard. Ron and Bill met in 1989 at GBMC when Bill removed Ron's gallbladder. I'm not a doctor, I didn't go to medical school, but as I understand it, a gallbladder is about 4 inches long and 1 inch wide. How ironic that something so small would be the catalyst for a friendship so large. Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Bill Howard.
Thank you. June, I'm honored that you asked me to speak here today, and thank you. We're not here today to mourn. One would hate that. But we're here to remember. Memories last forever. And I remember the shows when I was on with Ron. On the commercial breaks, we would wander outside and talk, and I would tell Ron stories. Sometimes I thought amusing stories. And Ron was always polite. He would smile and maybe chuckle, but he was no hypocrite. If they were bad stories, they got what they deserved. But I remember once I told a story and I got the full run. He started to laugh. His eyes squinched up. He leaned on the table. And then the laugh morphed into a full cackle. And the commercial ended, Ron stopped. Then he started up again. And I thought, I'm going to have my own show today because Ron's incapacitated. But we came back. Now, today, and I'm sure he's tuned into this today, in case he'd like to hear that story again, I'd just like to tell it, and you all can see what made that great cackle appear. And a friend of mine in Harford County, whom I will call Charles, died at a wake. Charles was from North Carolina, came up to Harford County, became a plumber, made a ton of money, built a nice, nice house, as if he was an old country boy. He liked to work in the lawn and the garden. Life was good. The only problem was the neighbor dog. Came over, dug up his grass, messed up his flowers, drove him nuts. One day at breakfast, Charles was eating, looked out, saw the dog in the flower bed, rooting up the flowers. That's it, he says. He jumped up, says, I'm going to kill the dog, going to kill the dog. Wife says, no, Charles, leave the dog alone. Says, I'll talk to the neighbors. Kid said, Daddy, we'll run the dog off. You just relax. I sat down again. Next morning, looked out the window. There was a dog pooping in the grass. That was it. Jumped up, grabbed his shotgun out of the corner, ran out the door, and the dog saw him coming. Boogity, 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 down the driveway he went. Charles in hot pursuit. Dog got to the end of the driveway, picked up the shotgun, boom! Dog ran across the driveway. Blap! Got hit by a car. Dog here, dog there, dog everywhere. Guy stopped the car, jumped out. There's Charles holding a smoking shotgun. He said, sorry, he said, I tried to stop and did my best. Dog ran out in front of me, couldn't do anything, did everything I could. Didn't mean to hit your dog. Yeah, well, he sure was a good old dog. Guy said, would 50 bucks make it right? Yeah, I guess that just about do it. He went back up to the house, said to his wife, best day of my life. And I think if we all listen closely, we can hear that chuckle even now. Thank you all.